I was going to say that. Colossians chapter 1. We obviously have been going through the book of Psalms, started last week in the book of Psalms on Wednesday night, so I'm going to start in Colossians tonight. We finished the book of Psalms last week. We did the first Psalm. No, we'll go back to that next week. But being Thanksgiving Eve, we wanted to change the message up a little bit. Thanksgiving is not seen necessarily, maybe in our eyes it is, but in the world's eyes, as a Christian holiday or a religious holiday. But I think when you look back at the very beginning and see what was behind this, let me read you a few things, and I'm going to speak about thankfulness, obviously, tonight. But here's a portion of the Mayflower Compact. That's the Mayflower, the big ship that sailed into Plymouth, where I grew up, with the English language and brought proper English to America. That's when the Pilgrims, you know, the Pilgrims would get out the boat and said, "Ka." Those are the same Pilgrims we're talking about on the compact. Just so you're aware that this is actually how it's said. So you might want to take notes. And this is what the compact said. Part of it: in the name of God, amen. We whose names are underwritten, the loyal subjects of our dread sovereign Lord King James, by the grace of God of England, France, Ireland, King, Defender of the Faith, having undertaken for the glory of God the advancement of the Christian faith. So it said more than that, but I just excerpted some of that out. So they saw this mission they had was for the advancement of the Christian faith. Now we know that was about 100 years after the Reformation, after Luther's Reformation. So the Reformation was still had been well established, and the Pilgrims very likely were people that embraced salvation through grace, by faith through grace, and they realized they couldn't worship like they wanted to worship in their locale, so they jumped on a boat and came over here and brought Christianity to Plymouth, Mass, where it all started in America. See, Christians out of Plymouth are actually the purest Christians in the world, probably, at least in America. Just, you might not have known that, but I want to share that with you. Now, about 150 years later, George Washington wrote a Thanksgiving proclamation. Portions of it reads a little bit longer. It says, "Now, therefore, I do recommend and assign Thursday, the 26th day of November, next, to be devoted by the people of these states to the service of the great and glorious being who is the beneficent author of all good that was, that is, or that will be, that we may then all unite in rendering unto him our sincere and humble thanks for his kind protection of the people of this country previous to them becoming a nation, and for the signal and manifold mercies. And also that we may then unite in most humbly offering our prayers and supplications to the great Lord and the ruler of nations, beseech him to pardon our national and other transgressions, to enable us all, whether in public or private stations, to perform out several and relative duties properly and punctually, to render our national government a blessing to the people." Who feels the government's a blessing today? Just feel blessed. I'm so blessed by my government today. It's changed a little bit probably since this. Imagine one of our more current presidents saying something like this. I said plural. I'm not picking on any president. I'm just saying, imagine, just, you couldn't read this today. You couldn't say this today without having MCS, them. And they're coming down and ragging on you. Okay, where was I? I don't know. Discreetly, faithfully execute and obey to protect and guide all sovereigns and nations, especially such those who have showed kindness to us, and to bless them with good governments. He's praying for the other nation, peace and concord, to promote the knowledge and practice of true religion and virtue, and to increase and the increase of science among them and us, and to generally to grant unto all mankind such a temporal prosperity that he alone knows to be the best. So here you go.